Hey, I'm Yara Willard from Harmonic Arts, and in this video I want to share with you a little bit about the Divine Feminine. This is a powerful blend of herbal tonics that has all different ways of working with the body. So come on and join us back at the kitchen where we share more about how to work with this blend. The ingredients in the Divine Feminine are Dong Quai, Ashwagandha, Shatavari, White Peony, Schizandra, a goji juice powder, maca, brown seaweed extract, a little bit of ginger, and a lotus pollen. All together, this makes a gentle, delicious flavor that hits right in the heart and opens up in the mind. So as I mentioned before, we like to work with formulation and Harmonic Arts in a similar way that has been done in China for thousands of years. And this is to create a whole tribe with one specific effect, but each player within it has a different action and a different way of supporting and embracing that. The main empress herb in this blend is Dong Quai. Now Dong Quai is specific as a uterine tonic, but it's quite nutritive and anti-inflammatory. It also has this ability to contract and relax the uterus, therefore being a little more sophisticated in its way in which it can be used. It's a blood tonic, so it's used for increasing better quality blood. Now this can also be useful for males too. If they don't have a uterus, you can still use Dong Quai. It's a great herb that way. It's slightly warming in nature, and just like every other empress in the world, she needs some support or else she's not that effective. So we don't really use Dong Quai on her own. Her ladies in waiting are the White Peony, the Ashwagandha, and the Shatavari. Now I'll start with White Peony. White Peony is another one of these uterine tonics that's also helpful for supporting the liver and is anti-inflammatory. So it's a great addition to this blend. Often Dong Quai and White Peony are put together because they work so well synergistically. The Shatavari is one of these female herbs that's quite driven. In fact, it's also considered she who slays 100 men or has 100 husbands. It's a little bit of a female libido, but it also gives more nutrients and energy to the body. It's quite a stamina herb, so it gives us more fortification and energy. Next one is ashwagandha. Now ashwagandha has been coined as the Indian ginseng, but it's not in the ginseng family at all. It's quite different. In fact, where ginseng might be heating, ashwagandha is cooling, more nutritive again that way. It's great for the mind. In fact, it's been used for all kinds of nervous system issues like, autism or MS or these types of things. But really what it helps work with again is the liver support and then adrenal stamina and energy. It's quite anti-inflammatory, so it's got a great effect on the body. And ashwagandha is used in many different arenas for having such a high benefit in the body. The next one is Schizandra. Now Schizandra, I call it Shazam because it's this bright berry that has quite a pronounced flavor. In fact, it's known as the five flavor berry, which means it's sweet, sour, bitter, spicy, and salty all at the same time. What this means in Chinese medicine is that it affects all 12 meridians and tonifies all five major organ systems. So it's used as one of these beauty tonics in Chinese tonic medicine. It's tightening and astringent and has a great way of just toning the whole body in general. The next herb in this blend is the goji. Now goji is another one of these tonic herbs that is more of a food, but it's used for its branched polysaccharides as an immune support and slight beauty tonic. So goji hits us in the heart that way and just a great addition. We use a goji juice powder because it gives us more potency to it than a straight goji powder might. The next one is brown seaweed extract. Now why an extract? Because brown seaweeds are high in something called fucoidin, which is a branched polysaccharide that is starting to take researchers by storm. In fact, this is one of the more immune modulating compounds we've found. It's similar to what the mushrooms have in their beta glucans, but it's in the seaweeds and we have to heat it in order to make it bioavailable. But this is shown to have those modulatory functions, so if we're overstimulated, aka autoimmune, it'll bring us down, or if we're lower, it'll bring us back up. This has also had some heavy research that's showing great results with working with tumor systems. So brown seaweeds are on the move and I think they're gonna be a super win for people's health in the next few decades. After that, we put in a little bit of maca. Why maca? Well, maca is one of these endurance herbs that gives us more stamina and drive. It's also a slight libido herb, but it's really useful for liver health as well as menstrual health in women. It's tonifying to a lot of the endocrine systems and chock full of minerals and vitamins. So maca is another plus we want to give to women, especially as they're going through their menopausal or perimenopausal years. It really increases the energy that way. One of my favorite herbs in this blend is not really a herb, it's a pollen. It's the lotus pollen. Now, this is something that I really dig in the sense that pollens have some of the most bioactive compounds that plants make. Super high in antioxidants, as well as free-form amino acids and supportive to the endocrine system. Lotus pollen in particular has been shown to help open up the heart and increase our spirit, giving us deeper connection to our third eye and intuition. Now it's also just super nutritive and tastes delicious. Lastly in this blend, we have a bit of ginger. Ginger is the circulatory stimulant taxi driver that I love to add into blends because it helps drive everyone else where they gotta go. And especially for a female tonic, it's great for the uterus for toning it as well as cramping or any kind of pain. Great for digestive health as well as many other aspects. Altogether, we have this delicious blend that can be easily used in many different forms. We can add it into recipes, we can make it into drinks, we can put it into smoothies, I've even blended it up in yogurt, playing with a little bit of oatmeal, there's so many ways. My favorite though has been just adding it simply to hot water or sometimes a tea. In the Divine Feminine's case, it goes great with a nice green leafy tea or a holy basil or ginger or lemongrass or any of these kind of types of tea. It's delicious with that, but I've also liked to use it just with water. We're basically gonna work with half a teaspoon per dose. We're gonna wanna work with that for at least 2 to 3 weeks, if not for a longer period of time. The reason is that many of these tonic herbs start working slowly, but then increase over time their benefit in the body. So this is one of those daily using, like a daily multivitamin. So finding different ways to work with it can be a nice way to start incorporating into the diet. If we can't, one thing that I've done with this that I found was great when I was on the go is I've made it into herbal pills. This is super simple. All you gotta do is roll the powder in a little bit of honey and then roll them out into small balls and roll that again in a bit more powder. Let those dry out for a couple of days. You've got nice little herbal chewy pills that are delicious because they're made with honey and easy to work with on the go. Let's make a drink just so I can show you how simple this is. And I'm just gonna make this with hot water. In this sense, I'm just gonna add a teaspoon like so to around 400 to 500 mils of hot water. From here, I could add in a bit of honey if I wanted, or I can add in a little bit of oil or fat or something else, plus maybe other tonic herbs if that's what I choose. But for now, we're just gonna go with this. Doesn't take long. To share with you a little bit about the profile of the flavor, the schizandra and the maca make it just a nice roll in the mouth, and you get this warm, glowy feeling from that ginger. Of course, with some of those tonics and toning of the abdominal tract, this one has a nice heat to it, but not spicy. Easy to drink on a regular basis. I hope you enjoy this blend. I know I do. Yes, I'm not a female, but awakening my divine feminine is one thing I am all about. So awakening our inner power starts from working with these deep tonic herbs and then incorporating them into a healthy lifestyle. Thanks for joining me. I'm Yara Willard, and this has been The Divine Feminine.